John, you're the person that Mr. Wise Sr. called to go to the house. Can you just walk us through what happened?
Yeah, but I had to call
I got to the house, I called the police, and I waited for the police to come, but before the police came, I got in the house. And I had another relative, my cousin. We waited. Once we got in the house, we waited and we sat there with everybody in the house. And we went back outside. We went and met the officer. We came back in the house and we started searching. The officer went in the room, and my other cousin went upstairs. I'm the one that found the bodies downstairs in the basement.
Can you tell us that moment? Just describe for us what happened.
I mean, it's nothing really to describe. I really can't. I don't really want to talk about that part,
Can you talk to us at all about Jesse? Were there problems? Were there issues?
Nothing that I know of.
Was he in school? Was he working?
Nothing that I know of. I'm always at work,
What do you do?
I'm a machine operator.
Oh, cool. Where?
Grubach Excavating.
Okay.
Can you talk to us about Jesse? Had anyone in the family said there were problems or issues, fights?
No problems at all. Everything was sweet. Everything was fine. No suspicions of nothing going on until we started getting worried that nobody showed up where they were supposed to be at.
In New York, you mean?
Yeah.
What were they supposed to be doing?
They were supposed to be in New York going to visit.
Okay.
The whole family.
That's it, yeah.
And when was the last time you talked to Jesse?
Yesterday when I got to the house and he was there.
So he was there when you got to the house and found the victim. What did he say to you?
He didn't know he had left at the time. He didn't know that I had found the victims at the time. It was just the three of us, me, another cousin of mine, and an officer. He had already left.
And when he came back, what did he say to you?
He didn't come back. When I found the bodies, I told the officers to go get him. He's the suspect, and they arrested him where they caught him at.
Where did they catch him?
Horseshoe Road, by the Conestoga Valley High School.
Why did you think he was a suspect immediately?
Of the different stories he's been telling me and my grandfather about where everybody's at. He's been driving the car around and stuff like that. And I got suspicious to it. I got scared. And I wanted to know what was going on. So that's when I got on the case about things. Now, if it hadn't me gone to the house yesterday, they'd still been down there.
So your grandfather had been talking to Jesse and getting different stories?
Yeah, he was telling me one story and then switching it up when he talked to my grandfather.
Can you tell
us? But I got the information from my grandfather that he was telling him, so we put it together that these stories are not matching up.
What was the stories he was telling?
He told me that they went to New York and that grandma had brought a new car. But all the fact, her Jeep was still at the house. So I left it alone. 3 days passed later, I got a phone call from my grandfather, Jesse, about how things are going down here. I said, everything is going well, but everybody else is in New York. That's what Jay told me, Jesse, So he says, I haven't seen nobody. And I said, what are you talking about? Jay told me they went to New York. He said, Grandma bought a new car and they all went to New York. He said, when I talked to Jay told me that Grandma's coming to New York in her car, in her Jeep, in a Mercedes. So he started talking more about it and he says, well, I've been trying to call Grandma on the cell phone. I said, Jay got the cell phone. I seen him on the phone with it. He said, well, Jay told me Grandma dropped the phone in the toilet. That's when it got more suspicious. That's before I went to the house and all that.
So did you talk to Jay at all right when you went to the house?
When I got in the house was barricaded from the inside, so I had to really push it in to get in. He helped me get in. Once I got in, I opened the door for my other cousin that went to the house with me. It was two of us. We went in the house and we talked again about it. And like I said, I just dropped the whole subject. I'm thinking everybody in New York, and he changed the story up again on me. So that's when I called the police. I had called the police originally when I got there. Mm-hmm. When I got in the house and noticed Jay was there, I canceled the call.
Because he told you everything was all right.
Yeah, everything. He said everything. When I called the police, I didn't know if nobody was there. So when I got in the house, Jay was in the house, so I canceled it because I didn't want nobody to come to the house and break in while he was in the house because I don't know what's going on at this point in time.
How was he acting? I mean, he's in a house.
He's acting, acting cool as calm, like nothing ever happened.
Did it smell? Or?
Nothing smelled until I opened the basement door and went down there. It wasn't really strong, but you can tell the difference.
Mm-hmm. At what point did you call the police again?